Morning St. Francis, News Team 2, Point 5, is here with you. I'm Jack Moretti.
And I'm Ryan Pekulski. Today is Wednesday, March 6th, Letter G Day. Please turn off and put away your cell phones and rise for the morning prayer and pledge.
In the name of the Padre, the Hijo, and Espiritu Santo, Amen. Gloria Padre, y el Hijo, y el Espiritu Santo, como era en el principio, ahora y siempre, por los siglos de los siglos, Amen. San Francisco, ruega por nosotros. In the name of the Padre, the Hijo, and Espiritu Santo, Amen.
The Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, the spring musical, Damn Yankees, is right around the corner.
Right you are, Jack. That means you should stop by the main office and pick up your free tickets to the show.
As always, each student is entitled to one free ticket, so get yours and come see the show.
Tomorrow will be the third student council dress-down day.
Remember, you can only participate if you have already paid.
Tomorrow will also be a mandatory Model UN meeting after school at 2:15.
Make sure to bring your resolutions for the March 12th conference.
Any usher that is working the musical shall attend a mandatory meeting tomorrow at 2:15 in the odd.
Raiders Against Cancer will meet tomorrow at 2:15 in room 3D. All members should attend, and there will be pizza. And nobody doesn't like pizza.
For those who signed up for tennis,
you should attend a meeting today in room 1M at 2:15.
Tryout dates and times will be discussed, so it is very important.
Well, that's it for the show. I'm Jack Moretti.
And I'm Ryan Pekulski.
Stay tuned. We forgot our dates.
Mark, how do you forget the girls for the dance?
No! No! Stupid.
She's gonna be so mad.
Oh God. We gotta go get them.
It's not working!
My name is Reverend James Davis. I am coordinator of the outreach ministries here at Hopewell Baptist Church. I oversee the prison ministry, evangelism, and outreach services. This was the vision of the pastor to have a strong outreach ministry.
Minister James Davis is a very devoted, God-fearing man, what I would call a marvelous blessing to our congregation. As a whole, he brings a unique ministry that we had long needed.
I came in contact with Reverend James Davis at one of our Erie County Reentry Task Force meetings. Very compassionate, and he was looking to try to start some type of group, a support group at his church, and wanted some program information and how would he go by doing that.
One of my first involvements with Catholic Charities was when I was a young father, husband, in my mid-20s, and I was laid off. Someone referred Catholic Charities to me. And I'll never forget, I was treated very kindly, very warmly. It's a tough thing for a man to not to be able to provide for his family. And I didn't handle the transition very well. I got into trouble and did some incarceration myself.
He was released from prison, and he went to Al Kenmore Catholic Charities office.
One thing I've learned from that experience is that how much people need other people.
Well, you know, Reverend Davis, he feels a need. There's a burning question, and the burning question is, what does your church stand for in your community? Not just solely a place of worship, but a place that people can come and get the kind of help and counsel that they need.
Catholic Charities is a large, comprehensive agency. If we cannot provide internally, we will link to another agency that does. Catholic Charities help with folks from all different races and backgrounds.
This work of the Lord is not a individual type of thing, or not even an individual denomination. And we need to partner with people regardless of their denomination and regardless of their faith.
I just thank God for where I'm at today. I have a lovely wife. My children are all grown up now and have great families, good families.
It touches your soul. To see that you touch another human being's life.
Well, one thing I love about what God has done in my life is that He's taken my misery and taken my shame, and He's made it my ministry. And we're praying that we can continue on to do good in our community with Catholic Charities.
Coming to you from Studio 313 in Friars Hall, this is Jake and Jay in the Morning with Jake Watkins and Jay Wilkie. They are bringing St. Francis Sports to you right now.
Good morning, Raider fans. Jake Watkins alongside my second kidney, Jay Wilkie, and we are here today with a special championship edition of Jake and Jay in the Morning.
Right you are, Jake. The Olympic officials may have voted wrestling out of the Olympics, but we have a gold medal-worthy wrestling team here at St. Francis.
The team is yet again the CHSAA Division II state champions, and they are the first team this athletic year to bring a trophy to our school. Along with that, the Raiders were also the MM League dual champions and the MM League all-Catholic champions.
St. Francis hosted the CHSAA tournament, which packed the gym with spectators from all over Western New York.
One of the main components to the victory was senior Sam Carosha, who was the most outstanding Division II wrestler.
It was the perfect end to a stellar season in which Sam finished 40-10 with 32 pins. That number broke a school record set back in 1997 by Bill Edwards, who had 28, and also ties him with seven other wrestlers in Western New York, with ninth most ever in a season.
We caught up with Sam, who talked about his amazing run this season and what he has for plans in the future.
Thanks, guys. Ryan Pikulski here with Sam Carosha. Sam, what have you learned in your 4 years of wrestling at St. Francis?
Well, besides a nice headlock, I learned that wrestling's really taught me how to handle things really well and how to be a man about things. I've had the pleasure of being coached by Coach Sore for the last 4 years, which is a great opportunity, a great guy, great coach.
Do you have any future wrestling plans for yourself?
Nothing in college, but I do hope to come back in the next couple of years and help out with the team. I'd love to be a part of the program as it continues and with its success.
Thank you, Sam.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Two additional records were snapped this year for our wrestlers. Junior Mike Miller won a total of 42 matches this season, which is second most in the school's history, just short by 4 wins.
Also breaking a record was Matt Muffaletto, who won 30 matches this season. That is the most by any freshman in the entire school's history. Being only a first year, Matt will have ample opportunity to break even more records in those years to come.
Exactly, Jake. Those three individuals were not the only athletes in the tournament to place, however.
Travis Bittner added a fifth place finish to his 23-win season, which matched Matt Muffaletto's placement in the tournament after his record-breaking 30-win season.
Mike Miller placed sixth following 42 victories, while Jimbo Canterbury scored fourth once he mustered up 29 wins on the year.
Jake Braunscheidel stole third place after 24 wins, while Dylan Sager managed fifth place following 25 wins.
Alex Misserman positioned in third place after achieving 19 Ws, and Josh Fisher placed equal as Alex, but added 7 more wins for a season total of 26.
Finally, Sam Kurosha placed second place after his outstanding 40-win season. All of the wrestlers' positions in the tournament and victories during the season was in their respective weight class.
Hey Jake, did you know that in 28 of the past 33 seasons, the wrestling team has either won or shared the MMAA League Championship?
I had no clue. No way, Jay.
I'm serious. Plus, now with 42 championships under their belt, the wrestling program has more championships than any other sport in St. Francis School history.
That is quite the amazing feat, and things look bright for the wrestling team to continue their winning ways, as 5 out of the 9 wrestlers who placed in the tournament will be returning next season.
We spoke with Mike Miller, who talked to us about the future of the team and some of his best moments of the season and tournament.
I'm back here with Mike Miller. Mike, what are some of your special memories from the season?
I'd probably have to say my most favorite memory is getting the trifecta win over St. Joe's. We beat them in the dual match we wrestled against them for the league championship. We beat them in the all-Catholic tournament as a team, and then again in the Catholic state tournament. We topped St. Joe's in all 3 events, and it was really exciting for the team to just know that we're better than them in every single aspect of wrestling.
How do you think the team looks going towards the future?
We definitely have a bright future. We have a lot of young freshmen that looked really good this year. A couple 30-win, a couple 20-win guys out there. Up top, we definitely need to get some recruiting in from the school this year, so if there's any big guys out there, we could definitely use you. But for the most part, I think we're going to be right back where we were this year, crushing St. Joe's.
Nice. For WSTFD, I'm Ryan Pekulski. Back to you, Jake and Jay.
On a final note, the Raider wrestlers are not only tearing up the St. Francis record books, but they are leading the way against all the other Buffalo area schools.
In the tournament, St. Francis held a 26-point lead over the second-place Buffalo team while demolishing the last-ranked Queen City squad by 150 points.
On behalf of everyone on the WSTF-TV sports team, Jay and I would like to congratulate all of the wrestlers who participated in a rockstar season, and also Coach Masseur, who led the team to victory yet again this year.
Everyone on the team should be very proud of what they accomplished this season.
Now, from the mats to the lanes, another celebration is in order, Jay.
This is true, Jake. Bowler Stephen Wong participated in the New York State CHSAA Championship on Long Island last weekend.
Over a 4-game set, Steven scored a 701 total, including a stellar outing in which he knocked down 221 points. Congrats on a great season, Steve.
Well, Jake, the winter sports season is officially at a close, and now we look ahead to the spring sports.
Correctamundo, Jay. Spring sports got underway on Monday, as baseball, lacrosse, track, and tennis are all ready to get their seasons underway.
Derek Jeter once said, "There may be people that have more talent than you, but there's no excuse for anyone to work harder than you do."
Remember that, spring athletes, and good luck to all of you in your sure-to-be stellar seasons to come.
That's all we have for sports.
I'm Jake Watkins.
And I'm Jay Wilkie. Back to you guys.
And don't forget, News Team 2.5 is here for you.
This has been a WSTF-TV production.